We asked a question that what are the jinns and can it affect the people, and he read a news that the two sisters who had bad jinn in them and they killed their father. News I haven't read, but as far as jinn is concerned, the two creations, one is the seen and one is the unseen creation. The angels don't have a free will of their own. Whatever Allah says, they believe. The human being and a jinn, they have a free will. They can either obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or they can disobey. So amongst the creation who have a free will are the human beings and the jinn. The human beings are seen creatures. The jinn, normally they are unseen. Normally, in normal circumstances, they are unseen. So these creations have a free will. So therefore the Quran was revealed for the complete world, including the jinn and the human being. Even they have a free will. Like in the human beings, there are people who follow Allah's commandments. They are the good people, like the angels, or better than the angels. Those who disobey, they become brothers of the Satan. Similarly, the jinns, those who obey Allah's commandment, they are good jinns and the bad jinns. The bad jinns are the Satan. And Allah says in the last chapter of the Quran, Surah An-Nas, chapter number 114, verse number 1 to 6, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ. That there are people who whisper in your ear and withdraw. These are the ones who are amongst the men and jinn. That means the Satan category, the evil category of two types, amongst the jinn and the men. The men who are seen and the disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are the seen Satans. The unseen Satans are the jinns. So the jinns is a creation which has a free will. Like human beings, there are good and bad. Similarly, in the jinn also, there are good and bad. And can they come in a human being? Yes, they can come. A human being can be possessed by jinn. And for this, the two surahs of the Quran, the Mu'azzatain, chapter number 113 and 114, the last two surahs of the Quran, the Mu'azzatain, the one I recited, Surah Nas and Surah Falaq. These two surahs were revealed as a treatment, as a remedy for this. So there are jinn. Science hasn't reached that far to completely identify this concept. So therefore, in science, there is no 100% proof jinns are there, but neither is there proof that there are no jinns. There are certain diseases which the psychologists say it is more with the brain, with the human body, and they cannot categorize in any of the scientific diseases which is known. Science hasn't reached that far. Maybe inshallah, 20 years later, 30 years later, 100 years later, science will advance and they will agree with the concept of the Quran. Since the Quran says there are jinn, we have to believe in it. There are good jinns, there are bad jinns, etc. But what we have to do, we have to have trust and faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the two surahs which have been revealed in the Quran for the treatment is Surah Falaq and Surah Nas. So regarding the situation of these two sisters, I don't know whether it existed or not. But you have to realize that to say that they're jinn, normally always say that people take advantage of the position and they try and make a fast buck. So you have people, you know, you go in every nook and corner in most of the religion, whether it be Hinduism, Christianity or Islam. You have religious people making a fast buck, fast money. They do something, you know, they throw some powder, vibhuti, this, that, whether it be Baba. So we have to be careful of that. And they take away from last month. My advice to anyone who says it's the person is possessed, show your child or your friend to a normal doctor. Then you can show to a specialist and finally to a psychiatrist. And after there's no cure, then you can search and say that it can fall in the category. Because normally some of the disease are more of psychological disease, which a layman will say it's a possession of jinn, which may not be. That doesn't mean jinn don't exist. Jinn exists. A human being can be possessed. And there's a book written by Dr. Bilal Phillips, rather the translation of one of the books on jinns and demons, that gives more details. And there are very few people who really know how to treat the jinn based on Quran and Sunnah. And normally the moment the person tries to make a fast money out of it, you can identify a shortcut. If he asks you for certain gain, then chances of him being in that category 99.99%. But if he initially doesn't ask for money, that doesn't mean that he doesn't fall in that category. He may later on milk the cow. Fine? So many a time they have a habit of milking big cows, the small cows, they leave aside. Oh, woh aadmi paisa leta hi nahi. Has to be a genuine case. You know, woh baba paisa lete hi nahi. If paisa nahi lete aapse, gareeb hai isliye, that doesn't mean that he's a genuine case. He may be taking from those people who are rich, and there are people who always approach and ask me to tell them that first go to a doctor, then go to a psychiatrist, and then if they give up all the hope and there's no medical treatment for it, then you can think of a possibility that it can be a possession of the jinn, etc. And then you have to approach a person. Actually, see his lifestyle. Lifestyle should be according to Quran Sunnah. If his lifestyle is not according to Quran Sunnah, how can he treat you? And the treatment is but natural. You have to recite verses of the Quran, the hadith mentioning that. But those who are the specialist in that field, go to him rather than to any person, Tom, Dick and Harry. Hope that answers the question. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.